back to global issues. Are we losing the battle in the gap between the wealthy and the poor?
Many of the middle-income countries is growing so fast, and they recover even from the crisis 2008. But it doesn't guarantee that they can provide with a shared prosperity in an equal way. And that is actually, you talk about the common concern. Mm. Are we losing a battle or not? I don't think so. I guess in this case, there are quite a lot of progress. But then there is also a setback, which is sometimes dictated or driven by the external factor. You just mentioned about food. Because of this food price volatility, 44 million now has been back to the poverty again.
Right. 44 million people.
44 million since last year right. only. If you talk about 1 year in which 44 million. If you talk about food availability, 1 billion people is still live in hungry. So this is
a
really
billion people in the world live in hunger.
Yeah.
A billion people.
A billion people.
So one, you can six, say, one sixth
one
of the world's
of the
population
world
lives
population,
in, go to bed hungry.
It is still, what you call it, a battle for us. And I think for any country, in the past, maybe it's been seen as just the responsible of many developed countries. So that's why you have this right. commitment to have the ODA and so on. But now many emerging and developing countries have an equal responsibility to deal with this development and poverty issue, with the hunger, with the food problem. And this has actually become the challenge of defining and building the new multilateralism.
Right.
Because you are now connected, interconnected world. This is a globalized world. It's rarely that you say that any problem has become a sovereign problem. Even if you talk about the global financial crisis now. The Lehman case here affecting when I was in Indonesia,
sure.
the economy is almost collapsed because of what happened here. So we need to work even closer, and the cooperation need to be rebuilt and redefined.
Did the attitude towards the United States financial leadership change because of the subprime crisis and the economic collapse?
Well, definitely what is happening now in Europe and United States is opening to the reality that even the most advanced country, if you are not managing and adopting a appropriate prudent policy, you are going to end up with the same thing like what is happening in many middle income or emerging developing country. So you talk about that.
You end up with having too much debt that you can't pay.
Too much debt, and then you have to take a very painful adjustment in order for you to then sustainable again and recover in a more equitable way. I think there are. This is exactly the same issue. And this is a very important lesson for many countries that actually you cannot be complacent, even at whatever level of income of the country that you are having.
You cannot be complacent.
About that you have become advanced country mean that you are not going to face with anything. You can face with a problem like demographic change. You have the issue of the public debt. If you talk about Japan, United States, Greek, and it's money of the European country. I think at the end, this is a very valuable for us to learn that achieving development is not like one state and then that's all. It's become a continuing endeavor.
Join us online at charlierose.com.